Hello, welcome back again in LADALIDI's tutorial. In today's video, I'm gonna show you how to create this rubber push button in Adobe Illustrator. It's look like 3D rubber button with metal frame. In fact, it's not made in any 3D software, I'm just playing with gradients in Adobe Illustrator. In this tutorial I'm gonna show you how to create a rounded metal frame first, then this blue soft rubber button in the middle. Lastly, give it a shadow to get a realistic 3D button. Other than that, at the end of this tutorial I'll show you how to easily change the color of this rubber button using Recolor Artwork. So without any further ado, let's jump into Adobe Illustrator. First, create a document with a size of 1980 by 1080 pixels. First, create the background by using the rectangle tool, with the same size as the artboard size. And give it a gradient color. You can see how I created this kind of background in my previous videos. As usual, I will lock this background by going to the Object menu, Lock, and Selection. Now we can make a rubber push button without being disturbed by this background being selected. Okay, let's start creating this button, by creating a circle using the Ellipse tool first. Make the size 710 by 710 pixels. Place it in the center of the artboard, using the Horizontal and Vertical Align tools. Click the Swap Fill and Stroke button, to switch the fill color to the stroke. After that, click the stroke box to bring it up, so the color will only affect the stroke. Increase the stroke weight to 45 points. Now, we're going to give it a gradient color following the path of these circles. Open the gradient panel. Before that, it's a good idea to change the size of this gradient panel, so that we can easily do many color stops. Point the cursor to the frame panel, and if two opposite arrows appear, you can click and drag away from the panel. With a longer gradient annotator we can easily work with multiple anchor points. And now, I want you to pay attention to this gradient stroke type. It will only active if you apply a gradient to the stroke. There are three types of gradient strokes here. Apply gradient within stroke, gradient along stroke, and gradient across stroke. To create a gradient along these circular lines is to use apply gradient along stroke. Just click there to activate it. And now we can start to create the metal effect using the gradient type of this stroke. In this step, we need a lot of color stops. First, I'm going to match the color of these two color stops to a dark gray color. Double click on it, to open the color swatches panel. And choose any color in the gray color group. Next, create a color stop by clicking the area between the two color stops below the gradient annotator. Click when a plus sign appears on the cursor. Double click. And choose a lighter gray color. Slide until it approaches the color stop on the left. Now, create another color stop, but for this one we just need to duplicate the existing color stop. Press the Alt key on the keyboard. Click, and drag the color stop you want to duplicate. Do the same thing until you have created a lot of color stops. Remember to make these color stops alternate, so the result creates a metallic effect. Set the color stop position randomly. If necessary you can experiment by giving it a different gray color. This may take more time, but the longer and the more effort you put into this step you will also get more satisfying results. I think this is more than enough. The important thing is that you've seen how to play with lots of color stops to create a metal look. After that, create another circle with a size of 755 by 755 pixels. Don't forget to center it using the Align tool. Open the Stroke panel on the Control panel overview. Set the weight to 3 points. And change the Align stroke to Inside. Open the Gradient panel, and simplify the previously set color stops, by removing some of the color stops and leaving only a few. After that, change the angle to 45 degrees. We create this circle to create an edge effect on this metal frame. Next. Create another circle with a size of 665 by 665 pixels. Also place it in the middle of the artboard. Open the Strokes panel. And make sure to align the stroke to outside. Open the Gradient panel, and change the angle to 45 degrees. We no longer need to set the color stops for this one, because the gradient color will automatically follow the gradient that we made earlier. And finally, click Reverse Gradient. And we're done creating the metal frame for this soft rubber button. For this gradient panel it's a good idea to return it to its original size to save space, so we can get a wider view for the artboard. Now, we will create the rubber button. First, create a circle with a size of 665 by 665 pixels. Use the eyedropper tool on the toolbar to sample the colors I've prepared. By the way, to create this soft rubber button, I use these 6 colors, apart from the gray color group in the swatches panel. If you want to follow what I did in this video, then you can screenshot this color palette. Okay, back to the eyedropper tool. Click the first color in this color palette, which is dark blue, or the name of this color is Violent Violet. Next, create another circle with a size of 650 by 650 pixels. Also place it in the middle. Before giving it a color, make sure that the stroke is none, and that the fill box is above the stroke box. Open the swatches panel and give the default color a black and white gradient. Open the gradient panel to edit the existing gradient colors. First, change the angle to 90 degrees. Click the color stop on the left, and activate the color picker below it. And sample the fourth color on the palette. And the third color, for the color stop on the right. Now we're going to give it an edge effect on the edge of this blue circle, just like the edge effect on this metal frame. Go to the edit menu. Copy. Back again to the edit menu. And paste in place. On the toolbar, click swap fill and stroke to stroke this circle while removing its fill color. Click the stroke box to bring it up, so that whatever we do with the color, only this stroke is affected. Then change the stroke weight to 4 points. And in the stroke panel, change the align stroke to align stroke to inside. Now, we will give it a gradient color. Open the gradient panel. Click this gradient annotator first, and change the angle to 90 degrees. Click the color stop on the left, and activate the color picker below it. Sample the 6th color on the palette. As for the color stop on the right, sample the 5th color in the palette, which is a lighter blue. And the base for this soft rubber button is done, and next we are going to create some more circles to make it look like a rubber button. Use the ellipse tool and click anywhere on the artboard. Make it 500 by 500 pixels in size. Place it in the center using the horizontal and vertical align tools. Again, click swap fill and stroke in the toolbar, and click fill box because we will only be working with fill colors. For this circle's gradient, we're just going to take it from the gradient that this larger circle has. Activate the eyedropper tool. And click this big blue circle to sample the color. After that, open the gradient panel. And click reverse gradient. And the result will look like this. It looks like a flat object that has a notch in the middle. And to create a rubber effect on it, we have to give it a smooth transition. So, to do something like that, go to the effect menu. Blur. Gaussian blur. And fill the radius with 27 pixels. And the result will look like this. Because we have given it a blur effect with a large radius, then we will find this blur effect cropped. For more details, I'm going to move it off the artboard for a while so we can see it clearly. We can clearly see that this blur effect is cropped on all 4 sides. We face this issue if we work with raster effect in Adobe Illustrator, such as shadow effect, blur, or glow effect. And this truncated part appears, because Illustrator gives it a pixel limit for the raster effect. Maybe Adobe made this with the consideration that your Illustrator doesn't slow down when working with raster effect. To fix this issue, we have to set the pixel limit for the raster effect in Adobe Illustrator. We can do this by going to the effect menu. And click, Document Raster Effect Settings. If you see this number, which is 24 pixels, that means Illustrator gives a limit of up to 24 pixels to the resulting raster effect around the object. So, if we give a blur radius of more than 24 pixels, the resulting raster effect looks like this. To fix this issue, we just have to change it to a higher number. Let's try to give it a number of 100 pixels. And click OK. If still nothing happens to the Gaussian blur effect in this circle, that means we have to reload the blur effect on this circle. Open the Appearance panel in the Window menu. And here is the Gaussian blur effect attached to this circle. To reload the blur effect in this circle, we just need to click the eye icon to hide and hide the blur effect. And you can see the result that there is no more cropped blur effect. After this problem has been fixed, place it back to the center of the button. The next step is to create a circle with a size of 380 by 380 pixels. Place it in the middle of the button. Use the eyedropper tool on the toolbar and sample the second color in the color palette. Give a Gaussian blur effect with a radius of 19 pixels. And the last step is we just give it a push text. Use the type tool to create the text. For this text, I'm gonna give it a dark blue color. After that, go to the edit menu. Copy. Back again to the edit menu, and paste in place. Use the eyedropper tool to sample the bright blue color on the color palette. Once it's colored, we're going to move it down a bit. On your keyboard, press the down arrow key to move it down, so it's slightly below the first text. Next, go to edit menu again, and paste in place. Reuse the eyedropper tool to give it a color from the palette. Down arrow key on the keyboard to bring it to the middle between the first text and the second text. And done. What do you think about this soft rubber button tutorial in Adobe Illustrator? It's very easy to create 3D rubber soft button only by using Adobe Illustrator. Now, I'm gonna show you how we can change the color of this rubber button without disassembling the button entirely, and without having to use the gradient panel again to modify the colors. But first, select all parts of this 3D soft rubber button. And I want you to pay attention to the control panel overview under the menu bar. And you'll find a circular button with pizza slices. Then this is Recolor Artwork, which allows us to change or modify all the colors that exist in the selected object simultaneously. Just click on that button. And this Recolor Artwork panel will open. Maybe you will find this panel different from the one I have here. That's because you have an old version of Illustrator. And if you have the latest version of Illustrator, then you just follow what I did here. First, make sure that the chain button is on, so that these colored spheres lock into position. To change the color of this button simply, you just need to move one of these color points. Once you get the color composition you want, just click anywhere outside of this Recolor Artwork panel to close it, and the color composition stays there. You can change the color again by clicking this button. After the Recolor Artwork panel is open, then try several positions to get a different color blend. And to make a shadow on this soft rubber button, you can see in my previous video on the card above, where you can see how I create shadows to impress 3D objects in that tutorial. If this tutorial was helpful, don't forget to like, share, and click the subscribe button and the notification bell if you want to get more useful tutorials in the future. If you have any questions, don't hesitate to ask me in the comment. See you in the next tutorial.